Not for the Bruni and Liz's total male makeover.
Britney Spears.
Hey, is your boyfriend a complete closet case?
Melissa Joan Hart.
Whether you're a potential stud with no personal style,
help is on the way. Stay right where you are because it's time for Britney and Melissa's total male makeover. Hey everybody, I'm Britney Spears.
And I'm Melissa Joan Hart, and for the next half hour, Britney and I will join forces to save a male fashion victim from hurting himself and others with his bad taste. He's been in a small room, kind of hidden away.
He doesn't know that it's me and Melissa.
So we're gonna surprise him.
Yeah, that we're gonna be making him over. And we learned a lot of makeover tips from the stylist who worked with us on the set of You Drive Me Crazy, my video for Melissa's new movie, You Drive Me Crazy.
In the movie, Drive Me Crazy, I play Nicole, and I live next door to my friend Chase. He becomes kind of beatnik, and I become very, like, preppy, you know, school spirit girl. We both lose our boyfriends and girlfriends that we want to date, so we decide to date each other to kind of make each other, the other people, jealous so we can get them back. In the process of using each other, I have to take him and kind of make him over so he's a little bit preppy so he fits in with my crowd.
We need to clean you up.
Oh, make me over.
The boy cleans up nicely.
Pretty shocking, huh?
I'm all I wanna be.
And actually, everybody's been saying Adrian, who plays Chase in the movie, looks better scruffy. But
I think so too. Did I meet Adrian?
He's in the video. So, in the video, your look, how would you describe it? What do you?
Well, at the very beginning, I'm a waitress, and it's kind of like a bubblegum waitress, because it's like pink and then the black and the glasses, so it's kind of like a sophisticated little waitress, uh-huh. You know? And then we all want to go crazy and get dressed up because we want to party.
Crazy?
Yeah, crazy, cool. Man. And so then I have like a little green top, and I show my midriff a little bit, and some black pants that I can really dance in.
When you're on stage, well, what are you going for? What do you want people to see you?
Really, it changes throughout the show. At the very beginning, I have like this pink top on and these white pants, and then I have overalls on. And I get really comfortable when I sing my slow songs. I have like this little pink dress on that kind of, you know, goes with Madonna, and then I have like this black fitted thing that, you know, represents Janet or whatever. Mm-hmm. And then at the very end, I of course wear the baby outfit, and it's just kind of glammed up a little bit different.
Talking about images and changes and stuff, and there's lots of celebrities that we've seen that have, like, you know, changed over the times or that influenced us or influenced probably all you at home.
Well, I like Madonna. I don't personally like her style. I think it's cool that no matter what she wears, she can get away with it because she's Madonna.
I think Madonna probably influenced me when I was younger, like really embarrassing, and you know, all the bangles and the
And the jackets and the boots and
new eyeliner and the hair and the whole deal. She's always ahead of the times.
Now she's in.
She does get away with anything.
Yeah, she totally does.
But she's classy at the same time. It's not like trashy, like at the awards, like Pamela Anderson. What was that?
Hello.
That's just cheesy, you know? But then someone like Heather Locklear comes out and it's classy but sexy, you know? So that's cool.
Julia Roberts always looks so stunning. Mm-hmm. She always looks really, really beautiful, really natural, and very classy. I really like what she wears a lot.
We're talking about image here, not personality.
What was your...
Well, in the movie, I'm dressed kind of preppy. Mm-hmm. But, you know, like, just normal, comfortable, like, I wear, like, little tight t-shirts and, like, denim skirts and stuff like that. Just just really kind of comfortable, plain, you know, nothing too fancy, nothing crazy.
So, like, how has your style changed from when you were really...
Well, when I was doing Clarissa, I was, like, 13.
Doesn't this look like fun?
The style on the show was very odd. It was kind of, like, mix and match. It was a little bit... ahead of its time, they said it was a big deal. The clothes were a big deal in Clarissa because it was all the torn up jeans. And my personal style was like tomboy, like total, like big baggy, like men's clothes. I would wear like the grips.
Really?
The grips would like give me their t-shirts. I'd wear like big baggy.
Just comfy.
So jeans and t-shirt.
Totally.
Yeah, no makeup, like lip balm and hairbrush, I'm set.
You know what? It was in the big bows. I'm sure you're about to see another huge bow on top of my head. I could just like fly away.
Carrie.
JC.
Brittany.
Get that thing away from me. No, I said no, okay? I wouldn't date you if you were the last boy on the planet.
This
this is what she wanted, was to sing. It wasn't really to do the Mickey Mouse Club. You know, she liked it, and that was fun, but that was just a stepping stone to the part where she can do what she's doing now.
My mom always put sponge rollers in my hair.
Oh,
and, like, the next day, did you do that?
My hair
would just be, like, out to here.
Mine never stayed, it always fell.
Yearbook. Don't you go through ugly stages, like, where you're, like, really, really ugly?
Only when you have yearbook pictures, yeah.
I went through a stage where my teeth were, like, really, really messed up in my hair, and I was,
if you ever saw Clarissa, I'm always missing teeth.
Well, there's one thing that I have to do every night. I have to floss my teeth. I feel icky and, like, gross. Sometimes I forget. I've been kind of bad lately, but that's one thing that I have to do. I like flossing my teeth, and I know that sounds gross.
I wish that was something I did. I need to floss more often. I'm trying to figure out, like, I've been breaking out like crazy recently.
I can't figure
out why. I'm like,
I have been wearing, like, a lot of makeup and being on stage and everything and sweating. When I was, like, 14 or 13, clothes really started to matter to me. Whereas before that, I was kind of like a tomboy. I was just like, whatever.
Yeah.
I went through a stage where I would wear cut-off boots and mini skirts.
Oh, no.
And I thought I was the hottest thing ever.
No.
And you know what? No one else was wearing that. Like, I thought it was just my own thing.
You went through a sexy stage, Rolling Stone.
It was really weird because I'm not like that, and it was kind of cool to see myself in a different way.
Yeah, it was
like,
you know,
being girly and just seeing yourself in a different way.
Kind of like grow up and grow out of styles and stuff, and I guess I started to dress a little different. I don't know, kind of like the movie line cover. It's kind of too much trouble to get all that glam all the time. Like you said, you know, doing the show and always wearing makeup and always being dressed up and wearing tight clothes that are all restricting, and then I'm like, go home, jeans, t-shirt. As soon as I get home, it's pajamas.
Normally, I'm just like now on the road and stuff, when I travel, I'm all about sweats and just
being comfortable.
Yeah, being comfortable. And like when I go to events and interviews and stuff like that, I have stylists to come in to help me out.
And like we're both not wearing shoes. I hate wearing shoes.
Stay tuned because we're about to surprise the king of pathetic
with a total male makeover.
I want him to be a really bad dude, but it doesn't work.
I just can't sleep. I'm so excited. I'm in too deep.
Welcome back, everybody, to Total Male Makeover. I'm Britney Spears.
And I'm Melissa Joan Hart. And I've got a movie coming out called Drive Me Crazy. And she's got a song and a video, Drive Me Crazy. I'm sure you've all seen it. Basically, in the movie, I take my next door neighbor, this cute guy, Chase, and I make him over into kind of preppy, you know, cute, nice.
Help him out a little bit. And that's what we're doing right now. We'll treat today's fashion victim to a haircut, a new wardrobe, and a little advice on how to treat a lady. But before we introduce you to the king of pathetic, we thought you'd like to meet some of the other guys who auditioned for the crowd.
My name is Franco Bravo.
In three words or less, why are you so pathetic?
I don't have a job. I can't get a date.
I'm hopeless.
I have no life.
I'm pathetic.
I seem to get picked up more by gay guys.
This schnoz is huge.
I'm kind of ugly.
The girl I love, Candace, she doesn't know I exist.
I can really stink up the bathroom.
I wear my name tag everywhere.
I have pox.
Got no balls.
Check him out. Number 4, Steven, 6'5", and single.
The reason why I'm here is to gain a little bit of confidence, because when it comes to girls, I'm scared as hell.
What about John? I mean, sweet guy, but he lives, sleeps, eats with his name tag on.
I wear my name tag around everywhere I go. I don't think I'm cool at all. I've never had a girlfriend.
Number 7, Ryan, aka Chicken Legs.
I always did think my legs were kind of scrawny.
Okay, number 8, this guy's name's Brian, and he's major Heartbreak Hotel.
That's Candace. I've been in love with her for about 4 years. She told me, like, flat out said that she wouldn't lower her standards.
One thing I'd like to change about myself is get rid of all body hair. From the neck down. It's disgusting. Don't have much, but what I have, I don't like.
I love black and I love red. And spiders. Spiders are my favorite. And also, again, spider webs on the pants. I love my pants. My friends like me to flame because I can just get into it, but I won't. And that's why I wear my flaming high top or platform.
Just about a week ago, I
moved down here from Arizona. And the whole reason behind that is because of a girl. I show up here in Salt Lake City a day, I'm crying, watching Armageddon and stuff, and just crying, and all of a sudden I'm like, what the heck? And I found out I got the chicken pox, and so it's been hell.
Okay, by the looks of those guys, you can bet our winner is gonna need some major league makeover help to become the perfect date.
Yeah, but what guy doesn't?
So what do you think, Melissa? Should we tell everybody out there the guy that we picked?
Yeah, let's introduce him.
Hi, my name is Trevor Thompson. I'm number 27. I'm 20 years old, and I've lived in Salt Lake City pretty much all my life. I broke up with a girl about 4 months ago. I've just kind of gotten back into dating. It took me a while.
She's still around. I talk to her occasionally. We're friends.
There's really only one other girl that I've really talked to or wanted to go out with since I broke up with my girlfriend. And her name is Emily, and she actually works with me. And I did ask her out a couple times, and she told me no flat out. And it was really brutal and heartbreaking.
This is the Heartbreak Hotel. This is the Heartbreak Hotel.
This is where I live. We're gonna see where I work later. So let's go inside and take a tour.
I like his style. I think he needs a makeover.
Brenna, Kenyon, Trisha, Andrea, Garrett, Melissa, Trevor, and Jill. That's all my kids.
I'm definitely the coolest one. This is my room. Welcome. I like Dennis Rodman. This is my model Porsche collection in the window. This is my one and only suit. These I like to wear dancing, something like that. This is my Fonzie jacket. This is my Hick hat. I bought it just for the Garth Brooks concert. These are my favorite jeans. Hey. This is where I work, at Weider Nutrition International. I keep record of every package that comes into this building that is not an inventoried item. After I'm done sorting through the packages, I load them up and I take them where they need to go.
His attire needs to be upgraded just a little bit. I think if you bring him into the 90s, the new millennium, he'll be on the roll.
You can feel little swan highlights things off.
Do something about the coloring, because this gray shirt doesn't do anything for him.
I don't know if he's a ladies' man. I wouldn't have that information.
I tried to
do. Do you plan to be a ladies' man?
He's adorable. We love him.
Breaks the girls' hearts wherever he goes. But, you know, he's just so shy. He never talks to anyone about it.
And that's all. I guess I better punch out.
Okay, this is the fun part, okay? Everybody knows now it's this guy Trevor, but he doesn't know it's me
us.
And Melissa.
You know, he's a Utah boy, he's kind of simple, so we're gonna see what we can do with him. Let's go.
Let's get rid of this
first. Yeah, we'll get rid of that.
All right. I'm ready to get rid of these, too. Let's
do
your Wranglers?
I'm excited. I really am.
Okay, so we went through, like, tons of tapes of guys and everything. And we know, like, a little bit of your story, but we want to know what's going on here, you know?
We found this picture of you.
All right, yeah.
This is what we figured. You look like a guy with a story.
Well, there's this girl at work. Her name's Emily. And I've asked her out a few times, but she really hasn't given me the time of day. So I was hoping that maybe we could get her attention.
Somewhere. Yeah, we'll help you out. We're definitely. Yeah, you're a nice guy. That's the base of it, you know, right there. That's where it all starts. And then we're just going to work a little bit on the outside. We've got hairdresser of the stars, David Evangelista. He's going to come out. We're going to do something here. We already lost the cowboy hat, so let's start.
Okay.
No, let's see, like,
we can lose this.
Let's get rid of the necklace here.
Right,
you get that. All right, you do the watch. I'll get the necklace. See, you're just my type.
Okay, and we'll get rid of the Wranglers.
Yeah, we'll burn those. And the hiking boots we can lose. And you know what? Here's your bathroom. Let's go get you started. And we'll see you after. And meanwhile, stay tuned, because afterwards we're going to take you through the makeover. We're going to show you, like,
shopping. We're going to go shopping. We're going to do everything. The hair.
The whole thing. We're doing it all.
Yeah.
Stay here.
Britney Spears cutting hair on MTV. Her
okay,
new
here we go.
Her second professor.
Seriously?
Oh, my God.
Just cut it?
Go, Britney.
Hello, welcome back.
I'm here with Britney Spears and Melissa Joan Hart.
And we're doing the Total Male Makeover.
And we're here because of my video and her movie.
Drive Me Crazy.
Yes.
So in the movie, I do a makeover on my co-star, Adrian Grenier. And we're doing a real male makeover here on Trevor from Utah.
Yes, dear.
So we got him in his robe. We're ready to go. We're going to bring in hairstylist and stars, David Evangelista.
Yes.
Come on in.
Hello. Trevor, how do you feel? You met your celebrity surprise.
I want to know what you know about hair since you got.
I know, right?
Well, I get the question a lot. Let me tell you. You know, a guy named Bic, B-I-C, does my hair.
He's really
a great, yeah, he's great stylist. You should try him.
I think he does my legs.
Oh, really? Yeah. Oh, my God, we have something in common. Who knew? On MTV, we have something in common, okay?
All right, so you're going to take Trevor.
Yes.
What are we thinking here?
Let me ask you guys something. What do you guys look for in a guy? I mean, you know, what do you see in a guy's hair? I want
to
ask you.
In a guy's hair, you know, I tend to be liking the shave, really, not quite as close as yours, but, you know, maybe a little bit of...
Okay.
No, just not my
opinion. You know,
my
I'm really
opinion.
Not really that picky with the guy's hair.
See, me and Brittany,
there you go.
I'm really,
to be honest with you, I'm not.
No, my new taste, I just realized, like, a lot of the guys I've been looking at recently have, like, the short, like, stubbly kind of...
Right.
I don't know if you want to go that extreme.
I like that look, though.
I don't want to shave.
I promise.
No, he'll take care of you.
But we're going to make you look hot for Emily.
Nice.
Yeah.
That's what it's all about.
What more do you want, all right?
That's Emily.
We want Emily, right?
Exactly. We want to get, you know, Emily at least one date so he can, you know, charm her with his charms and totally. And then take it from there. Yeah, let's do it.
Oh, make me over. I'm all I want to be.
I just can't see. I'm so excited. I'm in too deep. You guys want to help me? Yeah, okay. Just do a little texturizing and see what you want. I don't know what to do. I'm scared. Go Britney. Oh god, look at this. I want to see you try this. I'm scared. Wait, what do I do? Well, your left hand and her right hand. Just on my hand. You're gonna hold the hair up, okay, and then cut it.
Oh, wow.
Oh, my God. Britney Spears, cutting hair on MTV.
Here we go.
Her second professor.
Seriously?
Oh, my God.
Just cut it?
Go, Britney. Britney, oh, my God, we have a new future.
Really?
You know what? Why don't we trade jobs for a date?
Okay.
Wow. You're like, yeah, let him go
on stage. Okay, no, you do.
Trevor, you get to go to Kansas tonight.
Okay. Do you want to try?
Oh.
Okay, I know Trevor would love to have you cut his hair, too.
Wait, what about here?
So you can say all three of us, you know, had, like,
I'm getting into this.
But I love guy sweaters. That's cute.
How cool are these?
Ooh, a big scar. Hey now,
you're an all-star. No.
Look at zipper up, though. You're a rock
star. Oh. Yeah, that's hot. Yeah, that's okay.
I like that.
It's very
not really hot.
It's
very in right now. GQ man.
Exactly.
Let's
give it up. Come on.
Yeah,
take
it.
There we go.
I'll see you guys later.
We've seen Trevor go from like total male boy to stud boy. He looks
boy.
Hot. Now, if Emily doesn't take this guy, I'm going to have to.
Yeah, we're going to fight
hot.
Over him.
We're
about to fight. Emily's got some competition. Remember that now. You know, MJ and Brittany.
Yeah,
okay.
She's not the only fish in the sea, so.
Well, look, we really do have to go.
We have
I have a flight to catch. But, you know, good luck.
Thank you. And thanks for watching. And watch out for my movie, Driving Crazy, and her video. Vote for it, TRL.
Please.
Brad Pitt, Driving call in, TRL.
Call me.
Brad
Pitt. We got the new Brad Pitt
exactly.
Right here. The new It Boy.
You're over.
Here, we got these flowers for you. You got to give them to Emily. You know, use your manners. Be polite.
Don't forget the candy. Candy and flowers for a woman.
No, there you go. It's always the way.
Creme de la creme right there. Is that Godiva?
Hey,
I love Godiva.
Hello.
One piece.
It's for Emily.
All right, Emily.
I'm excited. Let's go get her. All right, we're going to pick up Emily. They've had a little bit of trouble getting a hold of her, so I hope she's home. I need to know. Is Emily here? She's here. Hi, is Emily.
How you doing?
Is Emily here?
I think so.
Emily! She's gonna hate me.
Oh my God!
family. MTV gave me a makeover.
How are you doing?
I was wondering if you'd go out with me tonight.
Tonight?
Yeah, these are for you also.
Oh my gosh.
I met Britney Spears and Melissa Joan Hart, and they made me over. This is my new suit.
Very nice.
What do you think of my hair?
You look great.
I got rid of those dirty pants too. Where you come?
What time is that?
Right now.
Right now?
Yeah.
Are you kidding me?
I'm dead
like,
serious.
You're all dressed up and I'm looking like trash.
Well, we can give you a few minutes.
Okay.
You look gorgeous.
All right, no. Okay, I'll go put these in water.
So will you go out with me?
Yes, I will.
Great. She's gonna go. This is awesome. This is everything that I ever hoped it would be.
I was gonna die. My little sister runs in and she's like, Emily, there are cameras off. Get in there. I open the door. Oh my gosh. You got that something. This is awesome. I love this place. Very cool.